Let's now design the algorithm for solving the genome assembly problem. Let's have a string and its three-mark composition, which is a set of all three-marks generated from the string. If we represent each chemo as a node, then the genome is a path through all the nodes. But can we construct this path without knowing the genome, but only from its composition? Well, yes, we can. We simply need to connect two chemos if they overlap by k minus 1 marks. In this case, for example, we have TAA and AAT here. We connect by an hash because they overlap by AA. Let's try to follow this idea. So we connect all the nodes that overlap by two marks. Is it all? Can we construct the genome path already? No, there are more connections. Because these chemos also overlap by two marks. Can we still find the genome path in this graph? I can. How? This is the way. Please note that I cheated a little bit here. Because these nodes are ordered according to their positions in the genome. Well, in reality, the position information is not available. So if I slightly reordered the nodes in this graph, then the task is more challenging. For example, in this case, nodes are arranged from left to right in lexicographic order. So the genome is actually a walk in this graph. Yes, and this path actually, what are the things that we are trying to find? We are trying to find the path that traverses every node exactly once. And we call a path that visits each node in a graph exactly once a Hamiltonian path in the graph. And the Hamiltonian path problem is that for a given graph, we need to find a path that visits every node in the graph exactly once. For example, let's look at this graph. This is a directed graph. Is there a Hamiltonian path in this graph? Yes, there is. But it's a little bit tricky to find. Here it is. Indeed, this is actually the game invented by William Hamilton, a great mathematician. But Hamiltonian path can also be applied for non-directed graph also, where there is no error on the hash.